our neighbor, he's so funny. We open up the door this morning to go out and vlog the new progress that we've done. And Kevin is standing right here. Oh my God, that is so funny. Since he's on our property, and take a look at this guy. Look, he put a real mask underneath. And this thing is freaky because it really looks like someone is standing there. I mean, he did a really good job of posing this guy. He looks like a beefy football player ready to attack his next victim. We were driving home last night from the grocery store and we found a log. It fell in the park, so we quick ran out and grabbed it. And it's so funny because we call those trees widowmakers. I'm sure some of you know what I'm talking about because the limbs on them fall all the time. So if you're strolling in the park with your loved one, you never know. You may be a widow when one of these falls. Yee! All right, so as you can see, there's a little bit more progress. We have some trunks at the train depot. We have a coffin on the Undertaker, and Kevin is standing right there. Dun, 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 is a saloon, and we put it at this direction so it would film the gap when people walk by right here. Pretty strategic, eh? So let's go check it out and hop over the fence. This thing, oh my gosh. You know, it's one thing to have flats and put wood on it and then take it down. It's another thing to have flats with wood on it and try to put it up with two stories. And I tell you what, this took us almost a whole afternoon. But it looks so awesome. We're getting so excited. Halloween is coming. All right, everyone. So we put a couple more facades up. And if you look over on the right, we have our Grave Rock Gulch banner that hangs high over our town. So when people drive by, hopefully they can read it and go, I think I'd like to go check them out on YouTube, Facebook. We didn't put Twitter though, because I hate Twitter.
And we're
really
horrible
do.
At it. I don't even think I've done anything.
One time. So if you follow us on Twitter, we apologize immensely because we haven't been up there.
We don't even follow ourselves on Twitter.
You want to go check it out?
Yeah.
Let's go check out this side first.
Yes, I have a weird wife. A little excited.
The worst motion sickness ever. I'm like, yeah, let's spin around. All right, so as far as this goes, we haven't really done anything new to it since the last time you saw, but
no, what
we
else?
We did add a luggage cart.
Yes.
I want to find an element to go right here. So whether that be a hat box or a lantern or some other piece of luggage, it just needs that third thing.
Yeah.
And you come inside here. We're going to put a chain that says, do not enter.
Do not enter.
Do not enter. So hopefully it's enough to keep people out. And then if you come over here, we're going to set a little scene up. We already got the clock. I have no idea what time it is though.
Because the arms are gone.
The arms are gone. So, but yeah, I thought it would be fun to set up, you know, maybe we could have a stamp and some tickets and maybe a skeleton in here or a little desk, something.
Yeah.
Put a little lantern.
But, okay.
Then come this way. Look at everyone. It's the first time you're seeing it all stacked together. And it's pretty cool because Christopher and I didn't even know what it was going to look like all together because when we made it, we made the two sections down on the ground. And we have the pole again that spins. So that's cool. And this signs up and the door doesn't really open. And the window and the tube and there. And ta-da! So this, I have an idea what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna make you guys wait because that's what I love doing. And
we still have to paint this side.
Yes, paint this side and a little access window.
Yeah, we have to paint the back wall too, mm-hmm, on the barbershop because it's not black yet. But just to give you guys an idea, while Gina's standing here, those of you who are curious how sturdy our structure is, I added quite a bit of bracing back here. Even though we don't get a lot of high winds, I mean, maybe in January they come, but this is definitely kind of overkill just to be safe. We still have to paint it all black, so it's not as noticeable from the guys driving down the road. But, you know, just to give you an idea, I mean, it has some wiggle to it, but
don't do that when I'm in here.
But I don't have to worry about it falling on anyone. Plus, and what we did is we locked the two buildings together.
Yeah.
So even though there's slope, like if you look in between, you'll see a crack there and touching down there, they are actually locked together with plywood and all kinds of goodies.
And the cart is locked to the deck too, and
yep,
so are the trunks.
Yeah, how we do this kind of thing is we not only screwed it in at that point, but there's also some chain that's going through the caster and locked down, so, and then the trunks are all screwed down to each other and the wall and stuff too, so yeah, making sure everything is all secure.
Yeah. We added some special stuff to the Undertaker, like I was saying before. So this is a photo op spot for the kids, so they can come and stand in the coffin a little tall, but they can do that, and it's in here,
yep,
really good. So, and I was going to put it kind of like over here, but I thought, well, if it's a family, they may want to, you know, all get in there or whatever, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, another one, and this one is not for people to stand in. This is for our canned food drive, so I'll put the sign, lay your cans to rest, and hopefully they'll fill it up all in here.
Yeah.
And then this one is another one that people can put their cans and stuff in. We have another coffin for right here. So we added some more stuff.
There it is. So we still have to add a few things. Cow skull is going to go up at the top.
Right at the top.
Yeah.
And we have that.
And we do have that. Gina's working on curtains and things for all these things, all mm-hmm, these facades.
Mm-hmm. This is cool. You guys are going to like this.
This is all up now?
Yeah.
We don't have it operating yet, but.
No. And I have to finish doing the painting for it. But look at this!
This is going to be our hunting little area. We're going to have, what kind of elements are we going to have right there?
We're going to have like our old rusty axes and pickaxes, and we have bear traps
and skulls.
And skulls and all kinds of gross stuff. So when the kids are looking for fingers and toes, they can also be looking at that and going, ew!
So, again, just to give you guys kind of an idea on some of our things we're doing for safety, we've got tons of bracing on this. Not only are all the flats screwed together and locked together, there's lots of boards going up, and they're all attached with several screws. Down below, I have some jacks, and the two of us put a bunch of weights. So, there's tons and tons of weight. Sandbags, and then also just to give you an idea. Oh, yes.
Overhead.
Yeah, just so we can sleep better at night, we have cable.
Yeah.
airline cable that is rated for way more pounds than this thing is, just to make it even safer. And then not only that, but all the facades that have these front decks, those posts actually help support this wall here anyway. You can kind of see where we put those posts up for our sign. We have one on the back side of the train depot and one right behind the Undertaker.
Now, because you guys are so awesome and you sat here and listened to this long shmeely, we're going to let you in on a secret. This right here, you can pretend, it's going to be our jail.
Yep.
Can you imagine it? With bars and everything? So this is what we're going to work on next.
Yay!
Jailbait.
No, you're not. Not anymore.
Oh, I'm old and wrinkly now. I'm saggy and droopy and...
All right, anything else?
No. They're probably like, you guys are on something.